Friendship is really important, and being there for your friends at a time when they've lost somebody that they love is an essential requirement of the term friendship. When my mum passed away, there was a bunch of things that the people around me did that really helped me, and I'm gonna share all of them with you right now. Number one, never avoid them. Sometimes the person who's dealing with this loss can feel like there's a dark cloud hovering above them, and all they're gonna hear from people for the next couple of days or weeks is, "I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry." You not being there thinking they need space is cool, and I can understand that, but sometimes they might need you just to pop up for them to tell you they need space. It's important for them to feel remembered and loved at this hard time of their life, because they may have never experienced something like this. Society doesn't teach us how to deal with these things. Sometimes when somebody's going through this really hard phase of their life, if they encounter somebody that they once knew and that person avoids them, it can be really damaging and hurtful. And I understand, you might not know what to say. Still greeting them, talking to them, and letting them know that you're there is a beautiful thing. And that's what they might need. And you could be that one person in their day that really helps them. Don't feel like saying sorry isn't enough, because it is. We all know we don't know how to deal with it, but that one encounter they can have that day with you might make them feel a little bit better. Number two, help out with practical things. I think some of the things that me and my family found really, really helpful at the time my mum passed away was people that were coming round and were helping us out. We was arranging a funeral, dealing with family that were coming from far, so many things, and yet basic essentials in the house and our work, things in life were still going on, and we needed help getting through them moments. Don't feel like you always have to be there emotionally. Sometimes the biggest help can come from practical support. I remember one time one of my friend's mum, who I've never really spoken to, turned up to our house with food and was like, "You guys don't need to cook, we've made it for you." I ain't gonna lie, we didn't really like her food, but it was the thought that really made us feel valued and special. Three, give them space to grieve. Space is really important. Keep a close eye on your friend, but understand that an emotional barrier and distance might need to be put in place for them, because this is really, really personal. They might feel really uncomfortable talking about it, and they might just not know how to deal with it. And that might be something that they come around to doing in time, but allow them to go through that at their pace. You can still be there for them to help them emotionally and practically. Just understand a bit of space can be healthy, but still be present. Number four, keep the memory of their name alive. I feel like a lot of the time in today's world, we don't talk about people that we've lost, and therefore their name becomes a taboo. So when everybody mentions that, everyone in the room is like, that shouldn't be the case. We should celebrate life and we should celebrate death. We should talk about fond memories. We should talk about happy times. We should throw it back, embrace them moments. I think especially with me, when my mum passed away, a lot of my friends were too scared to address the conversation, and it made me feel like they might not have liked her, or they're too scared to talk to me. And I'm like, bro, I don't want you to be scared to talk to me. I just don't want to be the one who's always bringing it up. That can really help. Ease into certain conversations if it's a little sensitive. Talk about the person that they've lost. Share memories. Embrace their name. Talk about their kind nature. Don't allow them to become a taboo, and don't allow them to feel like they can't talk about that person. Number five, identify the triggers. Emotional support is incredible, and if you can hit the nail on the head with it right, it will go such a long way into your friend's journey of recovery and healing. I know for me personally, it's things such as my mum's favorite TV show, her favorite cake, and her favorite shops she used to go to that sometimes really hits me. For some people, triggers can come from anything. It could be an ambulance siren, a certain name, a certain smell, a certain touch. But being able to identify these triggers for your friends can enable you to be there for them in an emotional way that you may not have once been able to be there. Thanks for watching, everyone. My name's Hussain Manawer. That was my first steps for you, designed by me. I know I'm not an expert, so some of the stuff you might have thought was real generic and real basic, but it is them simple things in life that can really help us out. Be the one to ask your friend, "You okay, mate? Let's talk mental health."